Oh, come on, you can do better than that. All right, people who are members of IBWA, you know how I do it. So, again, thanks for that generous introduction and acknowledgement. Many thanks to the presenting sponsor and for all the work individually and collectively to plan this annual event. And congratulations on this, the 32nd annual Berkeley Springs International Water Tasting Competition. When Bob Adele called me a few months ago to say that I'd been selected for the 2022 Lifetime Achievement Award, there was initial silence on my end of the call. Had my hearing been affected by the isolation due to COVID-19? Was I hallucinating? I was stunned into silence, and after a few seconds, I asked him to repeat what he just said, because I followed this annual event for many years and couldn't believe that I was selected for this great honor. I'm in good company with other recipients of this prestigious award, Joe Doss, Jack West, and Bob Heidel. While this is my first trip to West Virginia and I haven't traveled in 23 months, I'm delighted to be here this afternoon to share what I've learned about the intersection of bottled drinking water and ESG, environmental, social, and governance. During my recent tenure at Primo Water as Vice President of Government Affairs and ESG Programs. When I accepted this role, I quickly learned there was much to consider. Today's customers, consumers, associates, and shareholders are closely evaluating a company's purpose and values. How does a company demonstrate its willingness to fulfill the mandates of an ESG program that is clear and measurable? How can an ESG program not only be beneficial to your company, but also to society as well as help grow your company? This was a new program for our company, so I needed to determine reasonable starting points that aligned with our ESG initiatives,